My name is Pai. I'm from Thailand. I'm the founder and CEO of Localite, which is we are a social enterprise in Thailand that we work around the concept of sustainable development and sustainable tourism in Thailand. So let me take this opportunity to walk you through my personal journeys and also the dream journeys of how I think the tourism in ASEAN could and should be. I actually was born in a very poor village in the northeast of Thailand. I mean, basically the small village that I live in, the whole village, we live under the poverty line. I remember that I grew up with only this kind of thing, the papaya salad, because the only cheapest thing and easiest thing that we can find in my village. And now it's still become one of my favorite food, but I'm lucky that I can buy more side dish like grilled chickens and vegetables to eat with it. From then on, I think one of my goals is that because I live really under the poverty line, my goal is like to take me and my family out of poverty. So this is one of my first goals. So my family and I, we work hard since I was 10 years old. I was a laborer trying to save money and to save money for the education for myself and my families and my brother as well. So my family decided to spend all of their savings for my brother and my education. So I decided to went directly to engineering school because either not being a doctor in Thailand, you have to be an engineer in order to make much money. I got a job in Germany, so I was an engineer, the higher engineer in Thailand to go to work in Germany and transfer the production process from Germany to Thailand. So I end up being paid with a lot of money. So my first goal of get the family out of poverty is done. So now I can buy more land for my parents so that they don't have to be a laborer anymore. And also I save money for my further education as well. But at the very end of the year that I start working with these companies, I decided to travel. I took a 1 year gap of to travel. So my travel style is that I went on a boat trip, 4 day boat trip from the north of Chiang Rai to Luang Prabang to Laos. I took a 9 day road trip from the border of Myanmar and Thailand, go into the very middle part of Myanmar. From all of this traveling, it's kind of like opened my new perspective of, and also flat back to my childhood as well, where like we as like the local people, many of us still born in the area that there was not much of economic opportunities. And for those, luckily that for those area that become famous like Luang Prabang and compared to the Chiang Tung in Myanmar, the livelihood of the children is totally different. They can catch up opportunity from tourism, but this area they cannot catch up. Into a macro levels, the ASEAN region, we have 100 million travelers coming each year, and Thailand, we have 30 million of them. And we generate around like 1,000 billion Thai baht from this industry. But into levels, we know that only a handful, like less than 10% of that income go to local people, which is actually 80% of the Thai populations. So we seem to do very well on economic opportunity from tourism, but and at the end of the day, we're just building more money for the rich people in the large of enterprises like those hotels and tour operators, but we leave nothing for local people. We don't blame on those industries, but we have to come back up, okay, what to make the local people benefit more from that? The first thing is that because they don't have capabilities and also they don't have the market as well. For example, the practice of a better tourism is not there yet. Even in Thailand, and I think also the ASEAN regions as a whole, that where many, many local villages, especially the Hill Thai village in Thailand, they're being used as just a marketing tool, like the tour operators or big players, they bring in tourists and the guide from the tour operator explain, and then they left to another village and leave nothing. The only thing that the local can do is that to trying to sell their product, the handcraft, something like that. Otherwise, they cannot make more money from that. Sustainable tourism is kind of far behind. We have mad tourism here, but sustainable tourism in our region is still here. So I, from then on, I decided to work on this sustainable tourism in Thailand first. And the question that I asked myself is that how can we make tourism not just a and economic tool that the tool to make more money for the peoples, but also to look at as development tools for local community as well. How can we make sure that any villages that they decide to take on the tourism industry, how can they gather all the villages together to come and work together so that they have a better decisions? So I decided on to start my social enterprise, Local Alike. We want to showcase of how sustainable tourism should be treated in our regions and in Thailand. The first thing that we do is that we know that the local people, they lack of ability. So we work closely with them to introduce them and to work with them to so that to make sure that they get a better understanding of how to manage their tourism and how to improve their infrastructure in the local villages. Some of the villages, we took them like 2 years in order to get them to be ready for welcome tourists. And that whenever they are ready, we connected them with under our tour operator unit, which is the travel company that and also a marketplace. The travel company, we co-organize a tour together with them that utilize the concept of community-based tourism. The concept that is any kind of tourism that the villager they decide to take on, they have to manage by themselves. And the villagers as a whole, they have 100% say of what the direction should be. So we also discuss with the villagers and we want to make sure that they see tourism not just an economic tool. Talk to them so that we can utilize some of the money to develop their livelihood further on. So we contribute some of the money together with the villagers' income. We use that income to solve problems like waste management problems or educational problems and also any kind of problem that impact their livelihood as a whole. We know that the best way to tap opportunity from tourism is that the local people have to stand up themselves and to catch up that by themselves. And I believe that the concept of community-based tourism is one of the tools that can lead us to a better sustainable tourism in the regions because everyone get involved. And even though it might be a bit difficult to manage, but I think it's, at the end of the day, if they can manage, it's not just one decision, but decision as a whole village. And they know best. And I know that they know what to be, what is good and what is not good for their villages. And that is all the concept that right now my company, we work with 70 villages across Thailand and we are expanding to Vietnam and India now with the local partner in Vietnam and India as well, trying to utilize the concept of community-based tourism. And also we are not just focusing on development, but we make sure that the marketing and the economic coming in as well. Maybe you guys have any ideas to share, and because we are still at startup levels, like we've been operating for 5 years and we face so many challenges, especially how to get travelers to understand the concept more and also to understand that their decision of buying tour program is really important for local peoples and the whether that their decision is really important for them as well.
You know what the difference between the experience, the touring experience before and now after you've done the development in that area?
With the first village that I work with, there is no tourism at all in that village, but they want to tap that opportunity, I mean the local people. I worked with them for like a year, like the first 3 months I spent my life in the village just to get to know them. And after a year, we know that we are ready and I myself trying to sell the tour program to the tour operator in Bangkok, but none of them interested in us because they say that we can sell tuk-tuk tour, the Grand Palace and other tours in Bangkok. Why do we have to sell that tour from that villages? So there are so many questions like, is it clean enough or is it safe enough and something like that. So that is kind of like induced me to study more of why the tourism is like this in Thailand. So that's why I decided to work on full time as well and start the tour company just to sell the tour for that villages. And now we've been working together for 6 years. The villagers they now have a better waste management system using the money from the tourism. And now they have 9 local guides in that village and they do the trekking tour. This is one of the famous program that we operate right now.
Maybe talk a little bit more about the challenges that you're facing with regards to scalability. You were talking about expanding beyond Thailand. And I think probably if you have a model that's so closely based on engaging the local community, what are the challenges you face with regards to differences in local cultures? Something that I think probably will be much more pronounced once you go beyond Thailand's borders. How do you address that, and how do you approach your overall model and making it more scalable and diverse across regions?
People usually think that social enterprise cannot scale because we have to work a lot on the development side. But for us, like for social entrepreneurs, we know that we can scale, but it has to take time. We cannot scale fast, but at the end of the day, we can scale. Like for example, we move into Vietnam. We know that we have to take another approach. We cannot just build a marketplace and we enter the Vietnam market. We have to do development work as well. So the difficulties of social enterprise like us to scale is that we cannot do it by ourselves because we don't know the areas. We have to make sure that we have the best partner in that area as well. Like it took me like 6 months to trying to seek for local partners, those who have the same mission with us. And then when we find it, we kind of like sign an MOU together, and that they're going to employ our development process as well. And then we're going to use the same marketplace, which is the marketplace that we built. So, but they have to do development work, first work, because selling this kind of tour, community-based tourism tour, you have to really understand the products. Otherwise, you don't know how to market it, and you don't know how to use the right marketing approach. If it goes wrong the marketing approach, you will end up like with a negative impact for local communities. We have to, it's a very sensitive issue, and we are not similar to other tech startup that they can scale fast. Yeah, we have to make sure that all the development fundamental is there. And the challenge would be how to get to know the right partners, because we position ourselves that local life will not go into Vietnam and work there, but we have to have the local people to work for themselves.
Would you mind sharing with us some of the challenges that you have in engaging the local community? What are some of the, you know, like, barriers or some of the problems that you have encountered?
Working with local communities, it takes time. So we cannot just force them to do. We have to make sure that we work with them, not we work for them. Otherwise, it's not going to be sustainable in our sense. So not all the villages that wanted to do. We have to really make sure that we find the local star, those who really want to do. But they can, we also have to make sure that they can bring other people to come in as well. Many times that we went into the village that we can see only like couple people interested, but we have to make sure and to trust and to understand that maybe those people, I mean the rest of the villagers, they don't want to do it, but they don't know how to do it, and they want people to take the role first, and then they can come follow afterwards. And you have to understand that nature as well. And also, we don't try to introduce tourism as a main source of income. So whenever we come in, we have to make sure that we come into the right time. Whenever they do the farmings, whenever they do the fruit farmings or they grow coffees, we cannot do that. We have to make sure that they are free to work with us first. And that's why it takes time. I think that would be all for my sessions. And thank you very much. And whenever you travel to ASEAN region, so open your minds and try to talk with more with local people. And thank you very much, ครับ. ขอบคุณครับ.